Today I'm going to add a river with two waterfalls to my layout. I'm going to show you how it's done. All right, I need to make some clear sheets to represent the waterfall. And what I've done is on the glass top of my desk, I have built a little frame using clear silicone. Just put it around in a rectangle for the sizes I'm going to need, and then I filled that rectangle with Woodland Scenic's realistic water. I have tried using polyurethanes in the past to save money. Realistic water can be expensive, but I'm really not satisfied with the results I've gotten from cheaper products. Realistic water is what I recommend. You will be happy with the results using that. I poured this last night, so it's been drying for a little over 12 hours. I generally wait 24 hours. You can still see a haziness at the top part. That's because it's thicker. I put a little piece of paper under the glass to make sure that it was not level, because I wanted it thicker at this end and thinner at this end, just like water would be. Now I'm going to take you to my layout and show you my riverbed. I'm on the backside of my layout now, and as you can see, I have constructed the shores of my riverbed, and I have painted it. You will also notice that and using the colors, I put the darkest colors in the center and then use the lighter colors as I went out. This will give the appearance of depth. You don't have to pour the realistic water real deep to get the depth. You can show the depth with color. I've spread some talus in the bed, and I poured some a little realistic water over top of it to secure the talus. I also put in down here a twig to represent a branch or a tree that's fallen in. And when the there's another tree branch up here, it got poured a little thicker. When I poured this in, I also got a chance to see the level on it. Now, on the ends of my river, where it goes off into the world, it's not here. I've blocked it with goop. Goop dries very clear. Unlike the clear silicon, this dries completely clear, and it will meld in completely with the realistic water. As you can see right now, it's not melded, but when it dries, it will be. I've done this in the past, and I have some at the other end where the water goes off into the rest of the world. This will now up here. I haven't done that because when I lay the waterfall piece over, that will create a hump that will keep the realistic water in the bed. Same here with this one. It's also important to paint the back end right here behind it, because the realistic water will make it shiny even if you're not going to pour water there. So we're prepared now to begin, and as soon as my sheet of waterfall is ready, we'll cut it and put it in place. All right, I think we're dry enough now to remove my sheet of dried realistic water. Get my glasses here, and we'll take our razor and just slide it under. Now, you don't have to use glass. I've also done this on a sheet of plexiglass, and Woodland Scenic says that you can do it on wax paper, but I find glass works best. As you can see, it comes up very easily.
And you don't really need this piece of clear silicone on the outside. So we'll pull that off. And now we have a, after removing the silicone frame, we have a clear sheet. It's flexible, and I'll be able to cut it to fit my waterfalls. I've made enough so that I can put two layers on, and possibly three. And I don't know if it shows in the camera, but it's slightly thicker up here. So I can put on a thick layer and then a thin layer over top of that. So we'll take this out to the layout and cut it properly. Okay, we're at the riverbed. I've got some scissors and some goop, which I will use to attach my water. I'll just lay this up here, overlapping some at the top. We want that little hump at the top to help hold the water, the realistic water in when we pour it. So I'll just set it up here. And make a little snip there. And make a snip down here. Probably should have used some longer scissors, but these will work. All right. So, now that I have my it's on, we'll use goop to attach it. Just spread some across here. Spread some down here. Did you notice I spilled a little goop down there? Well, that's just fine. Don't worry about it. We're going to need some striations in the water anyway. So that will just add to the effect. Now this sheet of realistic water should take that bend there fairly well. Now later, we'll put another coat on this, and then we can also use either Woodland Scenic's water effects, or we can use the clear silicone to make other marks in it. But for right now, we'll just attach this and get it nice and dry, and I'll attach another one down here, and when I'm ready to add the second layer, we'll come back and start again. So we're back, and I've attached one piece here and one piece here, and the goop that attaches it is dry enough that we can begin to attach some more. I'm going to cut this piece. I figured out what I needed while I was waiting. And this piece is going to hang down here. It's actually going to lap over a little farther on top. And at the bottom, I'm going to feather it a little bit. This will seem a little crude when we first attach it, but when we start adding other water effects to it, you'll see why we did this. It will give the impression of different funnels of water coming down. All right, and we'll attach this the same way. Put this just behind the last one because we're going to overlap it. Again, making the hump just a little bigger. Let me see where the bottom's going to be, because I think I'll just put a little goop on the back of these to hold it. And I don't want it as thick here. Up on the riverbed, I wanted it a little thick because I wanted that hump to retain the realistic water when I poured it. But I don't need that down here on the base. So, put this over back here like this. And we have our second layer. And you can see it will become more defined with each layer. I have some extra. Again, I'll do the same thing I did down here, and I may have enough left to do another extra layer, but then again, it might be too thick, so I might do the rest of it with just the silicone, the clear silicone. But for right now, we'll let this dry, and I'll attach another piece to the lower falls, and when the goop is set, we'll be back to continue with the waterfalls. All right, I've added a second layer here, and now I'm going to do a third layer. I've already cut this piece and feathered it. We'll get both of these on because I want to pour a little realistic water in this session. So I'll put some goop here to attach, and a little on here. Remember, the goop dries completely clear. And I put another piece beside that because I want to continue that hump at the top. But you can see we continue to make the layers of water with a feathered effect. And do the same at the top. All right. Now, earlier I determined that I had a low spot here and a high spot here. Therefore, I propped up my layout just a little bit to try and keep it level. You want it level when you're pouring so that you don't have it thick in one place and thin in another. Realistic water should be poured thinly. You don't want very many, you don't want thick layers. They say 1/8 of an inch. Matter of fact, I have right here maximum depth 1/2 inch, but I don't think so. I think you'll be much safer if you use several pours. If you get in a hurry when you're doing water effects, you're going to wish you hadn't. So I'll pour this in. Pouring from what might be the shallow end and letting it drift down. If it doesn't drift all the way down, that's good. Realistic water is a little thick, and you can manipulate it with a brush. Or you can just let gravity do the work. Now eventually I'm going to have water that's going to cover the ends here. Looks like I've gotten it fairly level because it's not headed for that what used to be a low spot, so it looks like I've gotten it fairly level. I've also noticed using realistic water that as it dries, it shrinks away from the edges a little bit. I poured a swimming pool earlier, and there were a couple of times I thought I was done and had to go back and pour another. Okay. Looks like we've got a nice level platform here, so it's going to give me a nice even sheen. So what I've poured here is less than an eighth, maybe 3/32, and I will let that dry for 24 hours before I put my before I can do another pour. We will continue to pour until I've covered this hump and this one here, and then after that has after we've gotten all of our pour and the realistic water comes up and covers these edges on a waterfall, we will finish the waterfall with using clear silicone to make different water effects. All right, for this session we're going to be adding the water effects. I want to clear up two things from the last section that I made a mistake on. One of them was the instructions on the Woodland Scenics realistic water said that the pour should be a maximum of 1/2 inch with maximum individual pours of 1/8 of an inch. Do not pour it more than 1/8 of an inch at a time. And if you are doing 1/8 of an inch, 4 pours is the most you're going to do. And be sure to wait 24 hours in between. The other thing I stated was that goop dries clearly. Well, it has for me in the past, but I haven't used this with realistic water in a couple of years. They may have changed the formulation, I don't know. But as you can see, I have some cloudy spots where I applied the goop. Cloudy spots everywhere where I attached. So I'm not worried about that. I'm going to fix that right now. And what I'm going to use for the effects, Woodland Scenics water effects is very good, but you can also use a plain clear silicone. That's what I've squeezed into this little tube to make it easier to use the brush. And I also have a stick I got in my hamburger Denny's last night. So this is going to cover up. Now when you're applying the water effects up here, I have a large branch in the tree, and wherever the water hits the branch, it will come off in these like this little waves. So you just tap that on there like that, but make a V. like that. Same thing if you have a rock. You've got a rock sticking up. Make a little V. Yeah.
That doesn't help.
That's too light a touch, evidently. And here we'll make the V back here. Now the clear silicone doesn't dry completely clear. And so we're going to use it to hide this. So we're going to, where the water comes over, we're going to go ahead, maybe I'll use a brush here. Let me try it with that small brush. I have a brush I've cut the end off of. And we'll take it from here and run it over the top. And some more. The brush marks that are left in, you want. Let me see, I think I'm going to, I don't have any water falling down there, so let me put a little of this in there. Get my head out of the way. All right. Now, because the water effects dry translucent instead of transparent, it should hide this fogginess where I attached my realistic water sheets with the goop. Just run it all the way across like that. Now, for smaller waterfalls, just, you know, heavy rapids, something that drops maybe 4 or 5 feet instead of the, what do I have here, 35 feet in end scale, you wouldn't even bother with these sheets. You just go ahead and take your water effects by Woodland Scenics or the clear silicone, and you would go ahead and paint it on thickly on a sheet of glass or plexiglass or wax paper, and when it dries, you just take that piece, and that's the waterfall itself. Cut it to fit in the small area and put it right on. So I'm actually, what I'm doing now is doing that step on top of this longer sheet of water. Where it rapidly falls over here, it's frothier. That's why the translucent instead of the transparent that we see down here. Now here's a spot where I've got some goop to hide. But in here we want clear, both clear and transparent. Excuse me, clear and translucent. And later, we may even put some white in. Now white can be done with white water effects, or it can be done with paint. But we'll see what we need when we're finished. Okay, now down here, kind of just pat it in and pick it up. Pat it in and pick it up. Because here the water is splashing. Get some peaks. Because the water is roiled here. And we'll put some up in here. And up in here. And I will continue to do that. Any place in here where you think you might want to wave, just run it in like that. And get some on there. Run in like that. When that dries, it will be lines of ripples as the water changes direction here. The thinner you use this water effects, the clearer it will become. So, to cover my mistake with the goop, I have used the water effects. I'm not 100% sure what this is going to look like. There's a rock here, so it'll be roiling a little bit. So I'm going to let this dry. I'm going to continue and finish the lower falls, and I'll let this dry, and then we'll have another session, see how it looks, see what else I have to do to it. All right, to begin this session, I have cut off little pieces here that were sticking up. And as you can see, I've already been practicing with the paint. I've decided to use this thick acrylic titanium white. So I've put some in a little dish here. And using a dry brush, because I want to leave brush strokes. So I don't want the paint mixing together. I want to leave brush strokes. And I'll just run back, following my silicone. And it's really quite easy. I'm not being artistic. I'm just putting on the color. It's too thick here, so I don't want it heavy. I want it brush stroked. There we go. All right. Don't worry about making mistakes. If there's one thing I've learned in modeling, is that anything can be torn out and done all over again. So, just go ahead and get to it. And you see the white is helping to hide the cloudiness. If I can keep my head out of the way of the picture here. Let's put some thick paint, like white tops here. Okay. I've got a dab down there I don't want. So to get that out, I'll take the wet brush, clean it, and dry it. A little spit helps. But now before I dip this back in again, I want my brush to be as dry as I can get it. Again, if you get let water mix with this paint, it will flow together, and we don't want it to flow together. We want the brush strokes to show in it. Well, I don't want to overwork that. And over here, remember the cloudiness I had here. I'll just do the same thing. And the brush strokes will show the running of the water, put a little on the area where it hits the branch here. Oh, I've got some on the branch that probably shouldn't be there. Alright. And get a better view of this. So now the cloudiness becomes white streaks of water because it's rough there. And now all I need are some raccoons fishing, and I just bought those. And I think I'm going to have a nice little thing here. I need a tree here. I usually have one there, but I keep knocking it off, so I'm going to leave it off until I'm finished. But I pretty much have what I want now, and as you can see, it doesn't really take much. Let me remove this and move in a little closer so you can see. I don't know, the view I'm seeing in my camera makes the white look a lot whiter than what I'm seeing. So I'll go view this, and if I think you can get if I can get a better view after it dries, we'll try that. But this pretty much shows you how to do waterfalls and pour water, and I hope you've learned something.